Well, 興奮してるかどうか、that was a very, very interesting speech. So we're going to go to the working press tables as usual for the first questions. If you would like to ask Mr. Sato a question, please raise your hand and then we'll go to the rest of the room. I think I see Joel first.
My name is Joël Lejean from RTL France, Radio Television. I have just two short questions. What do you think of the announcement of yesterday by TEPCO that they are going to eventually resolve problems about radioactivity between 3 and 9 months? And if I may, and if the David allow me, I'd like to ask you as a governor precisely, how do the local prefectures, villages, cities and citizens have benefited of the generosity of the nuclear industry? Could you give us some examples, some precise data about how you were encouraged to accept the nuclear power plant on your territories, not only for your prefecture but others? Thank you.
First question is, 私が言えるのは、できるだけ早く皆さんの町に帰って、新しい町づくりをしようねと、それしか今、言えない状況です、それ言うのが精一杯でございます。ですから、何月何日にある程度、ゴールが見えたということは、今の避難民の方にとっては非常に気持ちがですね、ある程度、いい悪いは別にしまして、一つの目標ができたような気持ちであろうということです。私はそう言ってますけれども、しかし、とにかく一日も早く帰るようにしたいというのが、本当に私の気持ちでございます。それから、地元に対しての。
The first question was regarding my reaction to the announcement made by TEPCO yesterday. I would like to tell you that I've been visiting these evacuation centers almost on a daily basis, and I can tell you that the reactions of the people that I meet are that they want to go back to their homes as quickly as possible. And I believe that at present, that is their burning goal. And as a result, the fact that at least, although it was a very distant goal, the fact that they were given a month and a day when they might possibly be able to return is something that probably is helpful to them, something that they welcome. Having said this again, I cannot reiterate enough just how desperately these people want to return to their homes.
あまり長く質問に答えないように指示されてるんですが、一つだけ申し上げますと、彼らは、避難民は、さあ、体育館に集まれと、何の状況も説明もなく、体育館に集まれと、町長から言われて集まりました、さあ、これからバスで避難するよということで、隣の村に避難しました。自動車で来た方は自動車で行きましたけれども、自動車はその村まで全部つながったそうです。そしてそこで何日間か避難しましたが、今度は次の避難所に行けと言われまして、次の避難所で一つの例だけ申し上げますと、私が会った私と同年代の人は2畳1坪ですから、2畳のところに家族5人で今、いるんだよと、非常に幸せだよと、その前の避難所ではバラバラだったそうです、家族5人でいることの幸せ、そういうことを私に言っておりました。それから失礼。
I've been instructed not to speak too long, but I do want to tell you a little bit about some of the experiences that I've had visiting these evacuation centers. When I speak with the people there, they tell me that they have had no prior warning before they are moved from center to center. For example, they are told on one day to suddenly assemble at the nearest gymnasium. They are given a notice by the mayor. Once they assemble at the gymnasium, they are told we're now going to put you into buses and we're going to move you to the next town. People who came in cars had no choice but to follow the buses in their cars. There was apparently a line of cars leading to the next town. They stay there several days, and then several days later they are again told we're moving, again with no advance warning, and they're moved again. I could go on and on about this, but I would like to just give one specific example. I was speaking with a gentleman about my age, and he was saying to me, we're very happy with the evacuation center we're in now because the five of us, our family, were able to live in the same shared space. And the shared space that they had was the size of two tatami mats, which would be about the size of two of these tables. And he said, we're very, very happy because in the past evacuation centers that we've been in, the five of us have been split up, and at least we're together.
それから地元に対しての貢献でございますが、私、知事に就任して3年目でございましたが、ある町から増設のある町で増設の決議をいたしました。原子力が2つあれば、もうその町は永久に繁栄するんだろうというのが私のざっくばらんな認識でありました。しかし2つの原発を増設を決議を町の議会がいたしました。でその町が今どうなっているかといいますと、30年間は幸い人口も増え、そして農業はなくなりましたが、建設業にいわゆる原発関連の企業に行きました。30年後の去年おととしですか、町長の給料が出せなくて、ゼロになりました。もっと正確に言うと、健康保険料とか年金を町長は払わなければならないので、その分は町で面倒を見て5万円の給料が出ましたが、実質手取りはゼロでありました。私は昨年12月、今原発を作ろうとしている山口県に行ってそのお話をしました。皆さんが判断してくださいと。30年間はそういう状況に非常に人も増えます。しかし30年後は残念ながら町長の給料が出せないということは、財政的にはその町は福島県で一番60の市町村のうち一番ピリになっておりました。最後の町になっておりました。
ちょっといいですか。はい。
In regard to your second question, which was about what are some of the benefits that these local governments receive as a result of accepting nuclear power plants, actually, I was first involved in these decisions when I was serving in my third year as governor of Fukushima. A small town had accepted the building of two nuclear reactors in their area. And the town council had voted on it and had passed the resolution. I listened to the mayor and I listened to the explanations of the people involved, and I received the impression that once this town accepted these nuclear power plants, two nuclear power plants, they would be prosperous forever and ever. Having said this, however, actually it was that 30 years is probably about the amount of time that you can expect some kind of prosperity. 30 years has passed, and in fact 2 years ago I visited the town again. I spoke with the mayor. This was again exactly 30 years after the power plants had been built. The town's finances were in a shambles, so much so that the mayor's salary had to be cut. He received zero yen in salary. To be very, very surprised, the town people felt very sorry for him. He, after all, did have to pay his social security premiums and his health insurance premiums, and so they gave him enough money to pay for those payments, which was about 50,000 yen. But in terms of actual salary, spending money, discretionary income, he had absolutely nothing at all. He said, yes, for 30 years, things were really good. In the beginning, the population increased. Agriculture basically disappeared, but there was a great deal of construction work related to the nuclear power plants, and so people came. It was a thriving town. But 30 years from that point, we have no money left. Actually, I'm telling you this story. I told the same story last year to a group of people in Yamaguchi Prefecture, because they also are considering accepting the building of nuclear power plants. And I told them that it is up to you. I cannot decide for you, but this is the reality. Yes, you will be prosperous. You will receive subsidies, etc., and perhaps increased population, increased construction work for maybe a maximum of 30 years. But after that, you will find that not even your mayor will be able to receive a salary.
私の政治的な理念テーマの一つに、世代間の共生というのがあります。
I would also like to point out that this town that I mentioned earlier is ranked 60th of the 60 local autonomous cities and towns in Fukushima Prefecture in terms of prosperity. In fact, they are the most poor principality in Fukushima Prefecture. I would like to move on. In regard to my belief as a politician, I feel very, very strongly that as a politician, we have a responsibility as a person, we have a responsibility to make sure that we share prosperity with successive generations.
その地区はですね、瀬戸内海のクジラもおり、素晴らしい自然があるところですが、残念ながらそういう生物多様性はなくなる。しかし30年間は人口が増えて活性化します。しかし次の世代は分かりませんよ。世代間の共生はできないですよ。ということで、判断は皆さんに任せました。
I explained to the people in Yamaguchi Prefecture that this town that I was speaking of was located near the people in Yamaguchi Prefecture that I was speaking to, they are, were located in a coastal region on the inland sea of Japan, a very, very beautiful area filled with beautiful, lush natural surroundings. They originally had whales, and they did have some whaling industry for some time, but this kind of biodiversity is no longer that prevalent in this area. I told them, yes, I know you're looking to the future, looking for potential opportunities, and yes, if you take on a reactor plant, you may find that the population will grow and business will boom and the economy will thrive for some 30 years or so. But as I said, my political belief is that we have a responsibility to share wealth and prosperity with successive generations. 30 years from now, what will happen to the next generation? I cannot say. You have to make a choice.
Yes.
Süddeutsche Zeitung, Germany, Christoph Neidert. It's no accident that the power plants are in very poor prefectures. And like in Fukushima or in Niigata, the biggest power plant in the world is in Mr. Tanaka's hometown. Now, we know that politicians have been fighting to get power plants. In Fukushima, I was, among others, Watanabe Kozo.Do you think they were fooled, or do you think they were corrupted? Thank you.
Watanabe Kozo, of course, is a DPJ member, isn't that right?
He was not at that time.
Was not at that time. And he's the uncle of the current governor, is that right?
Yes.
Okay.
あの、原発を福島県に建設する頃は、アトムという、鉄腕アトムという漫画の本がありましたように、あの原子力というものは、あるいは原子関係というのは非常に夢の世界だったと思います。まだ皆さんその危険性やらその他ですね、理解しない時代であったと思います。ですから多分その当時、私は政治状況よく分かりませんが、あの渡辺幸三先生は多分あのその頃はまだ政治家になってなかったと思いますが、あのそれよあの質問に、ね、名前が出ましたので申し上げますが、あのそういう意味では、まあ、そういう時代であったということが一つの要因であり、特に過疎地域にとっては大変な宝物をいただくという認識があったのではないかと私の想像でございますが思います。
I would like to remind you that when the Fukushima nuclear power plant was built, this was an age when there was a very, very famous comic book that was popular. It was called Atom Boy or Tetsuan Atom. It was a time when people looked toward nuclear energy or anything nuclear as, some, as a wave of the future. They looked upon anything nuclear as being something full of dreams and potential and something that they regarded with great hopes.People at that time did not have an awareness of the potential dangers that were inherent in nuclear power plants. So I, of course, I was, don't understand all of the details about the political situation at that time. I believe, though, at that time, Mr. Kozo Watanabe, who you mentioned by name, so I will refer to him, was probably not even a politician yet. What I'm trying to say is that I think that was the age in which they lived. They really thought it was a positive thing, and especially for, as you've pointed out, very, very sparsely populated, poor prefectures, the being able to bring a power plant to your region was considered being able to, was equivalent to being able to bring a great treasure to your to our homeland.
付け加えて一つだけ申し上げますと、私が小学時代、60年前ですが、戦後ですね、私どもの遊び道具で一番強いのがレーザー光線というものでございまして、それが多分広島や長崎に落ちた原爆と関連するレーザー光線ではなかったかと思います。
I mean, just to give you an example of how different those times were, I remember when I was growing up and was an elementary school student, and this was in the
1950s.
Around the 1950s, I remember that my favorite toy to play with was what we call a laser beam. And when I think about it now, I realize that laser beams are probably very closely related in concept, at least, to the Nagasaki and Hiroshima bombs. But that was the time in which I lived. We didn't regard things in that way.
Fuyuko?
ドイツテレビの西里と申します。佐藤さんが、知事をお辞めになったいきさつですが、収賄事件だったと思います。そしてその収賄事件が、フレームアップされたものであるというふうに理解しておりますが、その原発との関係を簡潔に私どもにもう一度説明していただけませんでしょうか。
I'm Nishizato from German TV. I'd like to ask you about the events that led to your resigning as governor. You were led to resign because you were involved in a bribery case. My understanding is that you were probably framed for this. Could you please tell us in detail, very concisely, whether this had anything to do with your opposition to nuclear power plants?
欧州等では一般的でありますが、住民から市町村、そして県、そして国という流れがですね、日本の場合は国から県、市町村、住民、この流れが非常に強いです。
I would like to, begin by saying that countries such as in the, of Europe, for example, when things are decided in governments or when political decisions are made, it usually starts out at the grassroots level. In other words, the people decide they want something or they want to do something, and they bring it up to their local authorities. In other words, the mayors or whatever local governments are there. The local governments then take this matter up to the prefectural governments. The prefectural governments then take this to the state, the nation, national government. In Japan, however, this process is done in the reverse. In other words, the nation makes a decision. It's passed down to the prefecture, the prefecture passes down to the local authorities and then to the people.
私はこの流れをですね、県が頑張らないと逆に持っていけませんので、住民から市町村、そして県、そして国へという住民の視点に立った政治を行ってきました。
I felt, however, that this was the, an incorrect way for politics to work, and therefore I wanted to reverse this trend. In other words, I wanted to become a politician who always took the side of the people, the citizens, and to work with them to create a different flow, bringing matters up all the way to the national government.
詳しくは申し上げませんが、そうすると、すべての面で国とぶつかることがありました。たくさんありました。
As a result, as you can imagine, this led to many, many situations where I clashed with the national government. I clashed an incredible number of times.
例えば辞める年でございますが、大型店を規制する条例を作って、作りました。
For example, the year in which I resigned from the governorship, I put forth and had the law passed or directive passed to prevent the opening of large-scale stores.
環境問題では国よりも基準を高くしてはならないというふうな決まりもありまして、猪苗代の基準を厳しくするときに本当に苦労いたしましたけど、条例も作りました。
Another thing that I did to my prefecture was that I was very, very concerned about the environment even back then. And as a result, this was a time when local governments, including prefectural governments, were not supposed to set more stringent environmental standards than the national standards. However, for Inashiro, which is a very beautiful area in Fukushima, we wanted to make sure that it would be highly protected. And so I passed more stringent standards than national standards. But to do this, I had to struggle tremendously.
原発問題も同じでありまして、住民やあるいは地域からの視点で見ますと、手続きも含めてですね、どうもおかしなことが毎日のように起こるというのが実態でございました。
I faced similar difficulties in regard to the nuclear power plants. When one looks at this process from the point of view of the citizens or the people basically on the ground, when we look at, for example, the procedures that you have to go through to get anything done, there seem to be many, many things that were wrong or strange or funny.
国の方で長期計画を作る委員会というのを12月の20日前後に国で長期計画を策定委員会ですか、原子力委員会で開催することになりました。
The national government made a decision that they would create a new committee or commission. This was established under the auspices of the Atomic Energy Commission on December 20th. This commission was designed to formulate a long-term plan for nuclear power plants.
そこで申し上げたんですが、フランスは20年、ドイツは15年かけて決めていくようなテーマの問題、多分プルサーマルだったと思いますが、しかしその委員会では3回で結論を出そうといたしました。
I remember speaking about this matter when this committee was established. I said that the matters that they were going to be discussing, and I don't remember precisely, but I believe it was concerning the pluthermal issue. I said to them that this was a very, very serious, grave matter, and in France it would probably take 20 years of deliberation, in Germany at least 15 years of deliberation. However, this committee met three times and came to a decision.
後で分かったんですが、検事出身の女性の弁護士が、その当時私テレビ見てませんで分からなかったんですが、その委員がですね、挙手をしまして、佐藤さんは我々がこんな熱心に3回も議論しているのに何を言うのかということを質問として出てまいりました。
I learned later, I did not see this happen on television, but apparently one of the committee members was a female lawyer who was originally from Fukushima Prefecture. Apparently, on TV, she raised her hand or made some kind of a statement saying basically that, basically criticizing me, saying that Governor Sato, here the committee members have deliberated so hard and so earnestly for three times. Why are you standing in our way?
その経緯はこの本の中に詳しく書いてありますが、宣伝ではございませんが、その時、どうぞ。
If you are interested in the details, please buy my book.
その時ですね、それが原因かどうか分かりませんが、私は先ほど言いましたように、ドイツは十数年、フランスも20年だと思います。かけて来年結論出すんだよと。あなた方はマインドコントロールされてんだということを申し上げました。
Again, I don't know if that was the determining factor, but again, I spoke with the committee members and I said to them, I reminded them that you're considering something very, very important and usually in Germany it would take over 10 years to deliberate before you came to a decision. In France, some 20 years, and yet you're trying to make a decision for implementation next year. Are you perhaps suffering from mind control?
その4日後、すなわち日本でいうと仕事を納めの日に、アイラという雑誌の長谷川さんという後でこれも分かったんですが原発の専門家が福島県に質問状を持ってまいりました。
Four days later, and this was the last day of the year in which one still worked, because it was the end of December, a person named Mr. Hasegawa came to visit me. I learned later that he was an expert in nuclear matters. He came from the news magazine IRA.
その質問状が私が全然タッチしてなかった私の弟の会社の土地取引についての質問状でありましたので私はその社員かどうか確認してすぐ返事を出しておくようにこれは 2,3 日で分かることだからと言って返事を出させたわけでございます。
The questions that he had Mr. Hasegawa came with a list of questions, and in the list of questions, there was a question concerning land transaction that my younger brother had been involved in. And since I knew absolutely nothing about it, I told him that I would look into the matter and get back to him within a few days. I also want to take the opportunity to check his credentials and make sure that he really did come from IRA magazine.
まあ、それが直接的な原因かどうかは私は分かりません。しかし、そういういろんなことがありましてその次の2006年に逮捕されたと辞職せざるを得ない状況が安倍総理の就任した日の前の日に辞職しなければならない状況になったということです。安倍総理はあんまり関係ないかもしれませんがただ同州制も徹底して私潰しました。同州制が実は知事会で、詰めようとしているときに私が反対して、憲法改正と同州制が二大目標であった安倍総理でありますがその2ヶ月後にそれを潰しました。
So again, I don't know if this was all of these matters were interconnected or related, but as a result of after all of these events happened in the following year, 2006, I was arrested and I was forced into resigning basically the day before Mr. Abe became inaugurated as Prime Minister. I don't think Mr. Abe had anything to do with this, but I just mentioned this because the dates were around that time. I would also like to have her point out that I was very much against decentralization.
Federalization
or decentralization, thank you very much. And even though this matter had been raised quite vociferously in the prefectural governor's council meetings, I opposed this. I mentioned this only because Mr. Abe was in favor of revising the constitution and in favor of decentralization, and I happened to vehemently oppose both of those issues.
I believe the governor is not opposed to decentralization. 地方分権を推進されてるんですね。だけど同州制は反対されてる。
同州制は反対です。
Two different things. Sorry.
Sorry.
It's my specialty. Maybe you can move on to the next question, perhaps?
Yes.
No. We have an argument between two translators. Okay, we have time for one more question. We have six minutes, unless it's a very, very short question and a very short answer.
確認しておきますが、私の対応された原因についてはたくさんありますので、分からないという結論でございます。
I would just like to summarize by saying many, many things happened around this time. I don't know if any of those things were directly related to my being arrested.
All right. One more question before the governor goes.
Gentleman over there. Gentleman over there.
Sorry, whoever he is, I can't see him. Oh, there he is. Okay, sorry, please.
Siegfried Needle, freelancer from Germany. In your time in office, did you know about the different security standards against tsunami in Onagawa plant and Fukushima Daiichi?
震においてその津波対策の現状についてご存知だったんですでしょうか。
それは全然津波の問題については私説明も受けたこともないし問題に感じたことはございません。まあ、今回のこの事故の後ですね、歴史的な津波の状況その他も分かりました。
I never received an explanation from those related to the power plants about the dangers of tsunami and I myself did not have a very deep awareness or any real awareness of this as being a possible danger. Of course after the earthquake occurred I have looked into the historical records and seen what precedents there have been.
まあ、しかし、ご承知のように津波についてもいろんな問題を指摘してたという声がこの人災があってからですね私の耳にはいろいろ入っております。2002年2005年等にチリ地震並みの津波が津波が来たときに先ほど申し上げたような大体の電源がダメになるというようなことも指摘されてたというようなことも含めですね、あるいは去年の6月の問題等も含めいろいろ私の耳には入ってきておりますが知事時代には津波の問題というのは私自身は考えませんでした。ただ一つだけ最後に申し上げておきますと私がプルサーマルをプルサーマルにイエスと言わない頃ですねここにパンフレットあるんですが国は部長さんがですね22,150戸に22,150戸というのは原発地域の4町2村です。4つの町と2つの村に全戸にですね安全保安員ができたと何百人体制で安全を確認しているよとそれから原子力安全委員会というのがあってそれをチェックしているよと多分設計はその辺でちゃんとしているよというふうなビラをですねポスターを22,000戸に国が直接撒いてそして何重にも安全を確保してますよともし見たい方がいたら現物がありますからお見せしますがそういうポスターを全戸に巻いておりました。これは住民なら国がそこまで確認して、ビラを巻くわけですからみんなが2002年に私が原発問題に厳しい姿勢を取っている頃国は全面的にそういう構成をかけてたと。いうのは間違いありませんので、県民はみんな信じてたと思います。以上です。
I'm a freelance. When you say Kuni, what do you have in specifically in your mind? Is it some regime or a bureaucratic ministry or something?
これはですね、国の例えばこの原発に関しては。経産省であります。私ども分離しろと言ってましたが分離しないで自分の身の内に原子力安全保安員というのは置きました。原子力安全保安員が今一生懸命説明しています。私に言わせると政治家はタッチできないです。原子力政策はこの保安員の上にいる経産省の役人の人たち、なんでテレビに出てきて説明しないんですか、あるいは顔を見せないんですか。私が問題提起したときは、直接安全委員長に会ってですね、そして足元を救われるなんて安全委員長が言ったときには、足元を救われたのは私どもだというような話をして、マスコミ皆さんがその言い訳を聞いておりました。原子力安全委員長にももっと厳しく問題提起をしました。今説明しているのは保安員のナンバー2です。それを抱えている経産省の幹部はなぜ出てきて説明しないのかということですね。そんな無責任体制はですね、これはもう 大変関係者がいると失礼ですが、チェルノブイリを起こしたソ連ですね、そういう体質がいわゆるファシズムのですね、情報を隠して日本の他の役所もそういう一切記者会見やらないようなあの役所もありましたけれども、そういうソ連のような体質があったからチェルノブイリのような事故が日本で起きたと。まさに今こそ日本が本気でこの民主主義の問題に取り組まない限りまた起きるよと、10年前に私が述べたようにですね、また起きるよということを申し上げておきたいと思います。ですから今こそ非常に重要な時期だと私は思います。
When I talk about the nation or the national government in regard to the nuclear power plants, I'm thinking of METI, the Ministry of Economics, Trade and Industry. As you know, there have been vigorous debates about whether the Nuclear Industrial Safety Agency should be made separate from the METI Ministry because one is in charge of promoting nuclear power and the other is in charge of supervising it. However, although I have called for their separation for some time, nothing has been done. This is a situation where the politicians really cannot come to the forefront and make statements because they really cannot handle nuclear policy in Japan. They are not well versed in it. On TV, we see a representative of the Industrial Safety Agency explaining things. My question to him is, why doesn't his superiors come on television? Why don't his superiors show their faces? When I was speaking with these persons, I spoke with the heads of these agencies, and I said to them that you must take responsibility, you must come to the forefront and explain. They said that they were dealt with a very unforeseeable and disastrous situation, and they felt kind of lost. And I told them that if they felt that way, how do you think the people of Fukushima and that area feel. I believe that a much stringent, a more strong attitude should be taken toward these bureaucrats and to also the people in the Nuclear Safety Commission. Again, the person that you keep seeing on television is the number two person in that agency. I really think that they should bring the people who are responsible out into the forefront, and he or she should take responsibility. The point is this system right now allows for people to be irresponsible. I apologize if this statement offends anyone in the audience, if anyone was involved in Chernobyl, but the situation that we see in Japan now with the nuclear power policy is very similar to what happened with Chernobyl. In other words, it is almost as though we are in a fascist country where information is hidden from the public. There are some ministries who for many years even refused to give any kinds of press conferences. I believe that this is time for Japan to wake up and see what the situation is. It is time for Japan to take democracy back into their own hands, because if they do not, 10 years from now, we will see a very, very disastrous situation. I said 10 years ago, we must change things, and this is what happened. 10 years from now, I want to make sure that something as terrible or worse does not happen.
Okay, well, with that magnitude 9 political statement, we'll wind up. Thank you very much for your attention. Thanks so much to the governor for...